I am Jean Simpson, the Executive Director of Manna Meal Incorporated. Manna Meal is a no questions asked soup kitchen in Charleston, West Virginia. We serve two meals a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And we're serving right now an average about 410 people a day. What has always happened at the soup kitchen, we would get local donations. But what we never got was fresh produce. We never had fresh salad unless we actually purchased the products. Also, all the local grocery stores started closing down. Our only availability of any stores are a 7-Eleven gas store, grocery store. So there's no fresh produce. Our problem is with obesity in the state of West Virginia. The problem is diabetes. So I believe that it's because of all the processed food that we eat instead of eating fresh food. Myra came to me with the idea that we need fresh produce, not only for the soup kitchen, but for the people that came to eat, that they could also take fresh vegetables out of here.
I'm Myra Dolan, and 4 years ago, Jean Simpson and myself started the garden. We started the garden small because it's always an issue with volunteers. The good thing about volunteers for Manna Meal is we had a ready-made volunteer base because it takes hundreds of people, probably thousands of volunteer hours to get this going. And they come out and they give their sweat, literally, and their hours to provide food for the hungry. It's 100% feeding into the soup kitchen, and we grow what we need. We freeze what we need. And this being winter, we are actively using that food, so it really makes a difference here. We build community as we build our garden because our garden is all about the community and building and keeping that volunteer base. We have master gardeners that come, and they're coming for their hours because we are certified in the Master Gardener program, and we're doing outdoor classroom activities to introduce young children to gardens and produce. And we have a blog that we maintain. There are lots and lots of things behind the scenes that make it successful. We used all of our resources and begged and borrowed and got her going. Capital Conservation District gave us just a little tiny grant, $700 to get started. I guess we started out around 75 by 50. The second year we doubled it. Fourth year we're going to double it again. The reason we have to do that is because we're finding now in the fourth year we need to rotate our crops.
We went from 1,000 pounds or a little bit less the first year to almost 2,000 pounds to 3,000 pounds. If we can't get it in here and get it processed quick enough, then we put it on the bench and let people take it. I'm hoping that we can create more of a grocery store atmosphere, that we've got freezer space and refrigerator space for fresh vegetables. You know, maybe we have like a storefront for any of the farmers or people providing produce that they could bring us their leftover or their not sellable items. So what I'm trying to do and hope as a goal is that we can sit down and start just analyzing the problem with our neighborhood and people getting food. Because it's not only emergency food any longer, it's a daily need. You know, maybe it is a mobile unit that goes through the East End, all the different locations wherever we have created or understood that there is a desert, a food desert. One of the very first questions we ask when we're packing food up for people is, can you cook? And a lot of people, you'll be surprised that all they have is a microwave, or all they have is one pot and maybe a stovetop. Basic educational information, I think, is something we can work on, that in these food pantries, as we're passing out this food or making this food available, is also teaching them how to cook. When we had our old kitchen with equipment that didn't work, opposed to our new kitchen with all equipment that work, our whole quality of food has changed. You know, now we can roast vegetables. You know, now we can roast them, we can steam them, we can stir fry them, and we didn't have the capability of doing any of that. Now we've got the ability to even to buy spices to be able to go with or grow our own. But I'm hearing comments every single day. Boy, that was good. Boy, that was wonderful. Thank you so much. So, it amazes me how people without what I call without anything can come into a soup kitchen and stand in line, and you ask them how they're doing today, and the answer is, I'm blessed. You know, just because they're getting fed with real equipment and real food.